He lifts his unusually large for a four-year-old body up the steep steps of the school bus. My breath is catching in my throat, at once proud and helpless. I have been steadying myself for this journey since he was born. He seems impossibly young, yet fully independent. After boarding, he stands at the top step, takes one more brief look back at me and smiles. I'm watching my limb at the top of the bus. He takes his seat in the middle and waves from the window. No, 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 he cannot be getting on a bus. It's too soon. He's not ready. An animal-like sound escapes my throat, and Freddy, the bus driver, looks at me with his ear thrust to catch what I have said. I can't speak, so I just wave my hand, and he pulls the big lever to the side, and the door shut in front of me, and I stand stunned. Suddenly, I come to and realize with alarm I am still standing there. Oh my God, the car. I run as fast as wobbly legs will take me to my minivan, where I throw myself into the front seat so violently I bang my thigh against the steering wheel. Later, I will find a quarter-sized bruise there and wonder how I didn't feel any pain in this moment. The keys still in the ignition, I quickly turn them on and begin to drive. I don't have time or the presence of mind to put on my seatbelt. All I know is I must follow the bus. I'm in a cold sweat. I panic. I look in the rearview mirror to glance at the back seat. There is no child sitting in the car seat. My heart stops for a moment, but the immediacy of the situation jumpstarts me back into focus. Come on, come on, come on, follow the bus. I am watching the back of the bus. Is my son seated? Will he stand to look back at me? Is he talking to someone? Is he afraid? Maybe he changed his mind and he's crying for the bus driver to turn around and go back for me. Will something happen to him on this bus? I suddenly notice that I'm rocking back and forth at the wheel, and I am sweating even more as the panic escalates. At the opening to the highway, panic in full swing, I realize that I will have to wait my turn at the merge, and I won't be able to stay directly behind the bus. I strike the steering wheel with the bottom of my palm over and over as I wait for the large bus to merge ahead of me. My brain begins firing off options. Do I risk pulling out quickly with the bus? Is there a shortcut I can take to the school? The bus finds an opening and pulls out ahead of me. I accelerate to the end of the ramp. I brake quickly. Cars whoosh by me as I anxiously wait for a space to enter. I can see the bus rolling down the highway away from me. No, 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 I'm losing the bus. Oh no, God, please, no. I pull out, cutting off another car. Its horn blares in my ears from behind. I don't care. I have to catch up to the bus. I speed down the highway, down the off-ramp, and arrive in time to watch the bus make a wide circle into the front of the school. I follow directly behind until I am waved with friendly smile towards the side lot. I am not allowed to park in the circle behind the bus. They want me to park to the right of the school. Shit, 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 I mutter, my breath pounding the steering wheel again. I am biting my nails and circling the lot in a full-blown panic mode until I find a spot. I park on a crazy angle with slightly enough room to open the door and squeeze out. Barely having thrown the car into park, I turn the engine off. I leap out of the car, leaving the keys in the ignition. I don't care. Steal the van, for fuck's sake. I need to find my son. I scan the circle for him. Lines and lines of children are being directed into the school, but which bus is his? Where is he? I'm playing the Where's Waldo game, hoping to find my son's flaming red hair in the organized chaos of the crowd. There, I yell, making the person next to me jump and suck her teeth. I push past two people just in time to catch a glimpse of him parading into the school in a line. Rainer! Over here! It's Mommy! He scans the air towards my voice, searching for my face as I jump up in the air and wave. My son waves gently and peacefully back, his backpack like a large animal holding on to his tiny shoulders. I watch him walk into the building, waving until at last his outline disappears into the large waiting school. When he is completely out of sight, my knees buckle, I fall onto the curb, I put my head in my hands, and I cry. Thank you so much.